Hello and welcome. I'm Clipper Erickson, and I'm at the Newtown United Methodist Church in Newtown, Pennsylvania, where my wife and I lead the music ministry. I'll be recording this concert on the campus of Westminster Choir College. Before I begin, I'd like to give a big shout out to Melissa Bowl, who organizes these concerts, to Craig Levesque, who is my recording engineer, and to Nassau Presbyterian Church for presenting these concerts and giving us online performances when we most need them. Performing online is a whole new world, performing without an audience. I've done it several times now, and it's starting to feel more comfortable as I do it. I'm starting to collect these online performances and putting them on my website, www.clippererickson.com. I recently did a performance for the Princeton Summer Chamber Concert Series of Nathaniel Dett's music. For those of you who may have come to my earlier performances at Nassau Presbyterian, he is one of my specialties, an African-American composer. Recorded all of his piano music in 2015 for the first time. I would like to begin this performance with Jesu Joy of Man's Desiring. When I was choosing the music for this, I thought that I would like to offer music that gives us the comfort and the meaning that we need right now. We live in a time of unprecedented turmoil and anxiety, at least in my lifetime. And we need to remember who is in charge and who has our back. And there's no better way to do that than by this music by J.S. Bach, arranged by Myra Hess. David Finko, my great friend, is now 85, living in upstate New York in Fredonia. For many years, he lived in the Philadelphia area after emigrating in 1979 from the Soviet Union. When he lived there, his father was one of the top engineers for the Soviet Navy designing submarines. And his son was to follow in his footsteps. In fact, he went on several tours in the Arctic on submarines. Then he decided to become a composer. So that was quite an event in his life, and his music has an astonishing depth and strength in it, but very finely engineered, which shows his abilities and his talent in that area as well. I recorded his first three sonatas in 2018 on an album called Tableau, Tempest, and Tango. And since then, he is still writing. He has written a fourth piano sonata, and now just this year, a fifth piano sonata. So I will play the fourth piano sonata and read to you his notes. Sonata number four was written in 2018. The music of this four-part sonata reflects the inner world and general attitude of a highly educated and cultural intellectual of the 21st century. The first part, Andante Risoluto, is a reflection or even meditation on the problems and trials of life. At the pace of unhurried steps, the main theme sounds as a harsh, courageous melody. It grows and at times sounds menacing. The second movement, Giocoso, is a cheerful, playful scherzo with moments of perky humor. The third part, Larghetto, is a portrait of an uneducated, uncultured individual from the human mass who excites society with his presence, his demands, and aplomb. Whether this is a portrait of a certain figure in our national consciousness right now, he does not reveal. The composer himself told the performer how to play this music. It should be played lazily, cheeky, freaky. The fourth part, Largo Assai, this is a quiet, slow, melodious piece. The music of happiness and peace of mind. The composer specifically indicated how to play this music. Shyly, happily, innocently, modestly. The first three movements are like preludes to the last movement. The last movement is the center point of the piece, and I feel is very much in the vein of a self-portrait of the composer. So I offer this to him now, so he knows that his music is appreciated and performed the world around. Thank you. 2020 has been a year like no other. We are assaulted with turmoil and anxiety on a level that I have not experienced in my lifetime. But it is also a cause for celebration. It is the 250th anniversary of Beethoven's birth, and musicians all around the world are celebrating this. We are forced to celebrate it in a whole new way, but celebrating it we are. As part of the Westminster Conservatory's presentation of all of the 32 piano sonatas of Beethoven, I have performed the Opus 57 sonata, the Appassionata, and the Opus 53 Waldstein sonata for Temple University. And now I give you the last movement of his sonata, Opus 90. It is a very sweet, calming and melodious piece without the storm and the tragedy that you sometimes find in Beethoven's music, and I believe it is something that speaks to us right at the moment. Wilhelm Stenhammer is a composer that you don't run into very much. I found him when I was researching music by Swedish composers, since I have Swedish ancestry. And I find his music wonderfully attractive and beautiful. He was a pretty interesting composer, born in 1871 and passed in the 1920s. He was responsible in great amount for invigorating the musical culture of Sweden. Before his time, the Lutheran Church in Sweden frowned on instrumental music. And so vocal music was really the only music that was popular and was produced in Sweden until his time. And he brought to Sweden music by the great classical composers such as Beethoven, Brahms, Schumann, Chopin, etc., and performed widely throughout the country and was single-handedly raised the musical culture of that nation. His sonata in G minor was composed at the age of 19 and has much wonderful music in it. It has kind of the power and the passion and somewhat the impatience that you would think of a teenager writing, but yet it's very tightly controlled and very, very structured in a way that's very lean. So you have the romantic spirit translated into the Scandinavian style in many ways. I play the first two movements of this sonata. The first one is a quick allegro, very passionate and dramatic in nature, and the second one a beautiful and atmospheric romance.
Thank you.
On election day, I will be presenting a set of music for I Voted on ivotedconcerts.org. Election day has always been important, but never so much important as it is this year. We are told, it seems, every 4 years that this is the most important election of our lifetime. This time, it's true. So I was very proud to produce this set. So please do tune in and listen, but more importantly, please vote if you haven't already. Please do that and take any friends who haven't or need assistance to vote. I would like to close this set with the Lord's Prayer in an arrangement by my dear friend, Donald Dumpson. It closes the concert in a way that it began, remembering who has our back, who is in charge, who will protect us, and who will redeem the world.